All right.
You ready to go?
I agree with Ellie because if you think about it, she would be working and trying to get
supervisor's office and keep it on the table.
Good point. But I was looking at your paper and you said text connection, compare this to the movie. And you remember all those kids in Which Way Home, remember? They all had time.
Mm-hmm.
They were all alone, right?
Oh, well, he's signed it, right?
But basically.
Regardless, he was still on drugs.
Even with his mom?
Sure. I don't know. Because I know a lot of people, because they don't have any supervision, that's why they do things, because there's not many consequences. Like, I have everybody in there. I know, like, if my mom got home and I'm doing something bad, and I come home, she's like, what are you doing? And she finds out what I'm doing, she's going to try to get me to stop doing it.
But they wouldn't have the income to send Belky to school, right? I mean, if he wouldn't have had all the things, they would have been still in a bad situation. Maybe he would have turned to gangs because he needed the money, you know, extorting.
He wouldn't have had to go to school.
All right, let me put a question like this. It's been in my life for the longest. All right? Enrique. Do you think he's a hypocrite?
Yes.
Yeah.
Why?
Because when he had this girlfriend with Jasmine, at first he thought about leaving her alone and on the road because she was too young to actually travel all the way here into the United States. But then he was like, you know, kind of what his mom did to him.
I disagree with my eyes out because when he found out she was pregnant, she was already gone. So he was already leaving. He was already gone leaving. If he would have knew she was pregnant, he might have changed his mind, but I don't know for certain because he might have also just wanted to find his mom. So
I believe if he would have known she was pregnant, he would have taken care of her.
Because it's either two lives or his.
He's taking care
of me and his girl.
Uh-huh.
So he'd rather suffer himself because he would take the whole family.
But he didn't know. He was already gone.
He didn't know. She was 3 or 4 months pregnant before that.
Yeah, but 3 or 4 months pregnant, you can't say that.
Wait, so like, did he know that she was pregnant when he left?
No, he said he was...
He didn't know?
No. He went to his mind.
Alright, so do you think he thinks he's an hypocrite in any way?
I don't think he does because he was trying to bring his daughter to him. So she doesn't have to grow up without her.
Well, there's problems coming from where she is to here. That's like 4 years old. She's 4 years old. She could have gotten raped, abused, or even tortured.
She
got sold to another couple.
Hey, but that only takes the fact that he brought her, thinking about the fact that she thought what he didn't think about it. But he thought about it, not even the child at home. He was actually wanting to bring the child.
We have been.
Okay, but like.
Dangerous, you know.
So, let me give you a question here. How much would you have to trust someone to actually put your kid's life on the worst?
Well, definitely.
Like, seriously, how much do you trust someone? Like, would you trust anybody in, like, example, in this class to bring a family member, essentially, to handle them, to know the risk, like that?
What about you? What do you think, Danny?
Like, we saw one and we came back through.
Yeah?
Well, someone who was younger than 4 years old. I think, will they make it if they get separated? I don't think so. So that the big danger is that if the kid is left alone, it's not going to make it.
Well, they had, I don't remember the person, but they also had a family friend with them. So it wasn't like strange, it was a stranger around him, but the kid is still with people that he knows.
Yeah.
Remember the difference between how long it took my niece and I? How long did it take her?
It took two weeks, right?
2 weeks.
Yeah, because she had a Wyandotte. I mean, it wasn't a friend, but it was someone who knew the way.
Yeah.
But what if that trusted person didn't exist?
What do you mean? You think Enrique would have sent his daughter with somebody that didn't exist?
Yes. It's okay. Of course not.
So what if something happened to their daughter and
Remember in the movie, remember the little Salvador boy? Remember he was crying his eyes out at the Mexican police station?
Yeah.
Remember?
He was there.
Jose, his parents were sending him to New York. In the smuggler letter, the Toyota
letter.
So it all went go right to the smugglers?
No, it doesn't. It can go wrong. Alright. So just answer point blank, man. Was Lord, this is worth it? Decision worth it, yes or no?
Yes.
Point blank.
What do you think, Jimmy?
I feel like her going played a role in many other people's lives, but I feel like if she wouldn't have left all the people that it affected, it would have been worse for everybody. Probably she made it better for everyone.
Poverty?
Yeah, it would have been poverty.
Probably it would have been
like gang violence and everything there in the entire situation.
Okay, you guys ready? You ready to switch out?
Yeah.
Yeah, man.
That's 10 minutes. Is that okay, or did that feel like too short?
That was too short. Y'all was short.
Yeah,
that's too short.
You want to keep talking?
Yeah.
All right, let's keep going.
Y'all ain't got nothing to talk about. Y'all ain't been talking.
Jay, you guys have stuff to talk about?
No.
I'm waiting for it to get a little bit more heated. I'm just waiting for some heat.
Yeah. Well, put DP in there. I'll put some heat on it.
DP is going to be all talk.
Oh,
all right, let me ask some heat. Let me ask some heat.
Told you.
I pretty much switched. And I see what happened. I pretty much had it, but I got everything I said, everything I wanted to say. I'll just leave. Everybody else will come with me somewhere, but they don't even come with me.
It's time to switch.
Can I get to the next one too?
It's time to switch.
Okay, you got it. James coming through.
You know how Enrique's mom left him to have a better life on? What would you do in such a situation? Would you go?
What do you mean?
Would you go to meet your parent that left?
Like, put it into the United States.
So, if I was in Chile, would you have gone?
Heck yes.
Yes.
Alone?
Well, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
If I know where everyone my mom is, and it's better there, and it is here, now I'm trying to get myself to go, but get everyone with me to go with me.
Plus, think about it. What did Enrique have going for him in Honduras?
Nothing. He was just like a sniffing. He was just sniffing blue.
Gangs, poverty, kicked out, abandoned by everybody in his family. He was abandoned by mom, dad, grandma, other grandma, and his uncle, who got killed.
Well, that wasn't really
But the stepmom later, actually, he was abandoned, like, basically by everybody. And what would you do? You're going to just stick around in Honduras?
I experienced something like that. Like, my parents, like, they sent me away for, like, half a year, and it was kind of tough.
What do you mean?
Like, you miss the feeling of being with them.
Yeah.
It's not the same way your aunts or uncle. It's not the same thing. Because, yeah, they're family, but they need your mom and dad, so.
Yeah, in the book it said, that there's no love like mother's love. Now I'm watching Alejandro. Oh, okay.
If you were out